He's been really jumpy and having trouble sleeping. So our pediatrician suggested we see a therapist.
I think that was a good idea.
I'm fine, really. You guys don't have to worry about me.
You know what? Why don't you let Alan and I talk alone for a little bit? Would that be okay with you, Alan?
You can call me Brain. Everyone else does.
Okay, and you can call me Dr. Paula.
I'm not crazy, you know.
Who said anything about being crazy? Please, if a hurricane destroyed my office, I'd be a little jumpy too. How do you feel right now?
Great. Okay. A little nervous, I guess.
So tell me, what was it like when you saw the shop after the hurricane? Kind of shocking, right?
Yes. There was this tree sticking out of it and, we did everything we were supposed to. And if that could happen to our store, why not our house? Or my school? I'll never feel safe again.
Oh, I think you will. But things happen in their own time.
Is that clock right? Have I really been talking for an hour?
Yep. Time flies when you're having fun, huh? And when you're in therapy. How are you feeling now?
Better. Hey, maybe I'm cured.
Listen, it's going to take a little time to feel safe again. It doesn't just heal overnight. But we're going to work on this together, okay?
Hey, I called...
And exhale.
No offense, Dr. Paula, but I know how to breathe. I've been doing it for 9 years.
I know. You seem like an old pro. I'm teaching you how to breathe when you feel afraid. I bet you didn't know that sometimes I sing. And every time before I perform, I'm a mess. This fear climbs inside of me and takes over like a bully inside my head. Focusing on your breath is one way to stand up to the bullying fear. So the next time the wind blows, you give it a try.
But you were right anyway.
One Hurricane Sadie smoothie on the house.
Thanks. I love anything that's sweet and frozen. So, Brain, you're finally back in the shop. How do you feel?
Thirsty.
To watch more Arthur...